going to start with today's topic. Who are going to start? I start first, yeah. Later, see why I start. Because before I become not so awake, I need to finish my presentation so that later I'll pass it for CY to continue. No, the first mistake normally, especially those beginners or those even in the market for years, they will tend to make the mistakes of incorrect execution. Now, later I'll share with you what type of incorrect execution that normal investors will face or normal traders will face. But these are the common ones. First one is wrong order, meaning when they execute the orders, they execute wrongly. Now, according to this chart, for example, what is the current trend? I repeat, according to this chart, what is the current trend? If you think that it's a downtrend, you just need to put downtrend. If you think that it's an uptrend, you just need to put uptrend. So how many of you think that it's a downtrend? How many of you think that it's an uptrend? You just need to put downtrend or uptrend. So the first common mistake, incorrect execution, I will elaborate in details. But first, the question is whether this is an uptrend or this is a downtrend. Now, let's see how many of you answer this correctly. Down, I see down, down. Any uptrend? Because different people, certain people will see some short-term rebound, down, majority down, one, two, three, or many of you. Hing Long, Yok Long, Eileen, Alvin, Shah Shindran, or Ko Kwan, or many downtrend. Okay, so during downtrend, what should you do? So during downtrend, what should you do? So technically, if this is a downtrend, you should short the market. But sometimes, somehow, don't know what is happening. Some of you, in your mind, you thought about down. It's a downtrend. You need to execute a short position. But some of you, what you did is, you still click long position. How many of you done these mistakes before? Can you please put there? Yes. I believe this is quite common. This is like something like what we say, you want to send a bouquet of flowers to your girlfriend, but eventually what you did is you go and send it to your ex-girlfriend. Then that is the biggest jokes. So this is a common mistake that many of the traders will face when you during a downtrend. You're supposed to execute a short orders, but eventually you go and long it. It's very, very common. Later stage, I'll explain to you what should you do. Now, like for example, this kind of execution, if you wrongly execute, there are certain ways that you can confirm it. For example, now first, you need to check your orders before you execute. Meaning that after you key in everything, before you click submit, double check your order type. Whether it's not double check your order type, double check whether your action is correct or not. Whether you want to buy, you want to sell, whether is it correct or not. The quantity, the number of quantity, is it correct? If you want to buy one contract, don't go and key in 10 contracts. If you want to buy limit orders, don't go and key in stop orders. Or you want to put in a stop orders, you go and key in. You never change your order types, you remain as limit orders. These are all the wrong execution that you should avoid. So first thing, you need to recheck before you enter your orders. Double check before you enter. Now, second, another thing is after you enter your orders, you can go and check through your portfolio as well or your order tab as well. For example, after you enter orders, double check whether is it correct months, correct order type, correct action or not. So before and after, if you check, you can reduce a lot. Now, second, incorrect execution order types, that's the first order action, that's the first thing that normally people will wrongly execute. Second is wrong contract months. Now, this is very common. Now, first, for example, for FKRI, which month should you trade? Now, I repeat my question. For those who are trading in FKRI, which month should you trade? Can you please type in? For example, right now is in the month of May. I can't even recall what is this month because every day is MCO until you forget the month. Now, if currently is May, which month should you trade for FKRI? Please type in, at least I can see whether is it correct or not. If currently is May month, which month should you trade? Current month. I like this answer. Current month. Very intelligent answer. November at least. Oh, interesting. Spot month. Yes, either we use the terms called current month, which is the current month, which is the May month, or we use another former terms is called spot month, which is the current month. So right now, if you are trading, you need to trade May month. But sometimes, somehow, certain people, they will wrongly execute the order, the contract months. For example, maybe they will go and select December, select wrongly, press wrongly, or sometimes they go and select September. So wrong contract months is also very common. So if we go back to this, just now the example is like, you just now, you identify your girlfriend already. It's okay, you want to send a bouquet of flowers to a girlfriend, but you wrongly go and send to your ex-girlfriend. But in this case is what? You identify your girlfriend correctly, you want to send a bouquet of flowers to your girlfriend, but you go and send to the wrong address. You write the wrong address. So make sure when you select, you identify the correct trend, you want to long or you want to short. So when you key in correctly. But second thing, make sure that you key in the correct month. Now, this is quite frequently happen is because some of you, when you open your trading platform, you would like to have, like, for example, your own favorite list. So when you come up with your own favorite list, when the month change, you tend to forget to change as well. That's the first thing. Second thing, some of you like to use your mobile phone. Some of the trading platform, the mobile phone doesn't go in according to the month. So when you execute, make sure that you check, at least you check the correct month, check the correct year. This is very important because some of you will tend to go and select the wrong month, the correct month in the wrong year. I repeat that, some of you check the correct month, but in the wrong year, like FCPO. Some of you might go and execute the January 2021, not 2020. So be careful of first execution of wrong action, which is your buy and sell. Second thing, wrong contracts, contract months. So be careful of that. So for FKI, you need to trade for spot month. Now, how about FCPO? So for FCPO, which month should you trade? Let me know which month should you trade. Just give me your answer. Which month should you trade for FCPO? For those who are currently doing your trading, you should know which month should you trade. So which month should you trade for FCPO? I want to see. Test and see. Some of you still spot month. So which month should you trade for FCPO? Let me see. Oh, no answer. It's because there's a delay in my side or what? CPO. Oh, no, you're starting CPO, is it? Oh, third month. Oh, some of you, very good. Daddy, third month, some more put July. No, right now we are still, spot month is May. So the third month is July, correct? So make sure when you select, you must select third month. So if you do not want to memorize which month should trade, that you need to trade, what you need to do is you go and identify the highest volume month, you go and trade, you will not be too wrong. I repeat, for those who do not want to remember or you do not want to memorize which month should you trade, which is the third month, which is what we call as a benchmark month, what you need to do is you just need to look at the volume. Once you identify the contract months, double check whether is it the highest volume or not. Once it's the highest volume, you go and trade, you will not be too wrong. So be careful about that. This is a common incorrect execution. Another common incorrect execution which we do not want to write here is order type, usage of order types. But every different, every brokers, they are having different trading platform. Some of the trading platform, they limit your order type, so you are not exposed to that. But some of you, for example, you want to put a stop orders. Then you forget to change your order type to stop orders. It becomes a limit orders. Once you execute orders, it will immediately execute. So how many of you forget to put your stop orders? You forget to select your order types to stop orders before? You just need to put yes. This is a very, very common mistake. Meaning if you want to, you already bought one contract, you need to put a, let's say, for example, you bought one contract, you need to put a sell stop orders, but you accidentally forget to change your order types to stop orders, and it remains in default, which is the limit orders. So how many of you executed these order types wrongly before? Yes, want to exit, but and I'll add more position. This is very, very common. Meaning when you choose your order types, you choose it wrongly. Now, some of the trading platform, they do not have much order types for you to select. But some of the trading platform, they have a few order types for you to select. For example, they have limit orders, stop limit orders, market orders. So when you use these order types, first thing, double confirm before you key in the orders. So normally we will encourage people, if you want to place an stop orders, the trick of it is start to change your order type before you start to key in your price, before you start to key in your number of contracts. I repeat, whenever you want to key in a stop orders, first thing, change your order type to stop orders. That's the first step that you should change, rather than you go and key in the, for example, the number of contract first, or you go and select the months, etc. So please make sure you key in the stop orders, change the stop orders before you execute the orders. Because I can see, or many of you, Ken also, Alvin also, forget to change. This is very common. Even last time, when I was in my industry for very long already, after 5-6 years, sometimes we execute the orders. We are so used to executing the orders. Sometimes you execute it wrongly as well. This is very common. Don't worry. You are not alone, definitely. So first thing, first mistake that is very, very costly is you incorrect execution. And incorrect execution is something that you can overcome. I repeat, many things sometimes you might not be able to overcome, like psychological things. But when it comes to incorrect execution, this can be avoided. For example, just now we mentioned to you, before you enter your orders, double confirm. After you enter your orders, before you key in, enter, recheck whether your order type is correct, order quantity is correct, price correct or not, correct contract months. Before you enter, you press the button, enter. So these are some of the things that you can do. And this incorrect execution is something avoidable. So you must try to avoid this type of mistake. So one times, two times, careless is okay. Now, very important things that I want to remind you all. Whenever you execute wrongly, you must close your position immediately. I repeat, like for example, some of you mentioned, initially I want to buy one, I need to close, sell a position. At the end of the day, you go and buy additional one. So if you encounter this mistake, what you need to do is you directly sell two, no matter what. Now, the biggest problem is what? Many of you tend to do what? You tend to buy time. Meaning what? You tell yourself, I wrongly executed the orders. Maybe I go and execute a new orders. I wait. At least I break even. Meaning some of you, you will try to get the lux. Like for example, at least I make 1 point. 1 point. I break even, I cover my wrong execution cost, the execution cost. Then once I manage to get it, then I will close my position. Never do that. Because you know why? Sometimes the market will go against you. So if 1 point, 2 points you don't cut, then 3 points, 4 points, you'll never cut anymore. So I repeat, please, if you wrongly execute your orders, please close your position immediately. Very, very important. Because we see before, many of you try your luck, wait for a while. You tell yourself, I wait for 5 minutes. I just need 1 point. But sometimes 1 point, it never reach. Then at the end of the day, you open 2 positions and you are going to lose more. So be careful about this. Now, remember CPO is 3rd month. Don't forget about that. Now, second mistake, not rolling over. Now, unlike stock, please be careful. Stocks, some of you, you bought your stocks, then you leave it there forever. Until the day you have the stocks, you also forget about it. Now, futures, unlike stock, futures, it will expire at the end of the month itself or at the end of the months that you have selected. So please remember that whenever you have a position, you put into your calendar or you put into your reminder when the time comes, please remember to roll over your position. Now, look at this example. Some of you, you might have this experience before. You short a position here. Then eventually, when you check your position, you thought that you short at 1530. You're supposed to have the position when the market drops. But only you notice that on 28th of February, when the market closed at 1482, your FKL contract, you forget to roll over. So when you forget to roll over, the contract doesn't roll over by itself. The contract will auto-close for FKLI. Don't forget about that, yeah? So when the contract auto-close the FKLI contract, meaning what? It's equivalent to you do not have any contract. So at the end of the day, you only make these 50 points of profit. That's it. When the market dropped here, you thought that you're having a position. When you open your statement, you see, oh, I do not have a position. So this is a very common mistake as well. But for those having this contract, FKLI is not that bad because it's cash settlement. At least you're not making money. Worst case is what? For those who are having, this one is for FKLI, I believe you already understand. At the end of the contract month for May, the last day will be 31st of May. Or if you are in April, will be 30th of April, you need to close and roll it over to June. Don't forget. Now, the problem is with FCPO. Now, FCPO expire on which day? Can you please help me to type in FCPO, which day expire? The contract, not the last day, yeah? CPO, which day is the expiration day? Which day? Let me see. Hing Long said yes, because suddenly see my boss beside me. That's why I execute the wrong orders. Very interesting. Now, when is CPO is expired on 15th, so on 15th itself, you need to roll over. But the problem is sometimes you forget to roll over. That's the problem. So you must remember to roll over on 15th. That's why you see, we can see some of you already written there 15th. Don't forget about that. But if you forget to roll over, no issue, because at least your July contract on 15th of July, if you forget to roll over August, you forget to roll over to August, when it comes to 16th of May, you're still having July contract, it becomes the second month only. No issue. But don't forget, if it becomes fourth month and subsequently you need to take the delivery, then it's a big headache. You're going to see the crude palm oil sent to your doorstep. But it's a joke, I mean, definitely it will not send to your doorstep. But be careful about this, because this is a common mistake by many of the traders. You forget to roll over. Now, when it comes to expiration, remember we have two types of expiration, the way they settle the contract. One is by physical delivery, one is by cash settlement. So FKL is cash settlement. So if you forget to close, it will auto-close for you. It will auto-settle for you. But for FCPO, it's physical delivery. So if you forget to close, your contract will still be running until it becomes the spot month. So be careful about that. Now, if you open your accounts with those established brokers, when it becomes the spot month, brokers will remind you. But be careful about that. Okay? Now, maybe the next one, I pass it over to CY to continue. Ken? CY, your sound? CY,
okay.
Your sound?
Yep.
Okay.
Okay. All right. For mistake number three, most people make mistake is that they are undercapitalized. So now is that you already have a good trading strategies. You may have already a good trading system, but the problem is that you are undercapitalized. So what does that mean? The business of trading futures is like nothing more than just a business, right? It is not about excitement. It is not about the thrill of having some adventure. And I'm certain that you know that the number one reason that most businesses fail, and more than we have been ever told, is that they are undercapitalized, which means they don't have enough money to open their business. They don't have enough bankroll to survive when times get tough. They just don't have enough money to keep the doors open. For example, this MCO period is a very good example for us to learn. Many small businesses don't have sufficient backup funds to survive the storm, and they are forced to close down. So here, it is the same thing as futures trading. Even if you already have a profitable trading strategies or trading system, if you are undercapitalized, well, trust me on this, you will get margin call easily because of the market volatility. So it is very difficult to be a successful futures trader if you trade with scared money or with limited funds. Because trading with limited funds, by default, you already have a high probability of losing because you don't have a trading edge. So being well capitalized means that you have sufficient funds to trade, and that's a good money management. So here, now we look at this example. So let's say whichever you trade, for example, whether you trade FKLI or FCP or so, we use, let's say, an initial margin of 4,000. So if any time when your futures portfolio drop to the value below the initial margin, which is 4,000, you will receive a margin call from your broker to top up your funds back to your initial margin. So how much should you need to have in your bankroll to even start trading one contract? And here is just only a general rule. I think a beginner futures trader should at least have 1.5 times margin, initial margin, and 2 times is much better. So 1.5 times of initial margin, which is your 1.5 times of your 4,000. So 1.5 times initial margin, which means it would be 6,000. 2 times initial margin would be 8,000. So if you do not have the minimum requirement of 1.5 times the bankroll, you will get a margin call very easily. So what happens if you don't have the 1.5 times bankroll? So very simple is that you just go on paper trading to learn the skills and the test out on your strategy. And different trading system uses different multiples of money management. They have different types of money management. For example, our graduates in our ATM is that they have 12 trading systems. Each of them are back-tested, and each of the system requires different funds to trade. So remember this, trading is just like doing business. Good businesses are built for long-term and are financed in a good money management. So that's how you should be building your trading business. And the reason we need to have sufficient amount of money is that there is a high probability that your first trade or second trade will not be a profitable trade, right? So therefore, with limited funds, you won't have enough money to continue in this game. So how can we go about it, which is on paper trading? So we are so fortunate that, you know, in trading futures or in stocks, we can paper trade. And I know paper trading is not the same as real-time trading, right, with real money. And many people undervalue the importance of doing paper trading. Now, let's think about this. Virtually in every other businesses or profession, right, they have a form of paper trading. As an example, for example, for those students who are in third year of law school, law students have their mock trial, right? And doctors, they operate on a corpse before they really cut into you or me, right? And for a trainee pilot, they need to fly on an airplane simulation before they even actually flying a real plane. So if doctor, lawyer, or even pilot can learn their skills by their way of paper trading, then it is a good practice for us to use paper trading as a training vehicle for all of us. So even today, I'm still paper trading to test out new trading strategies. I don't use real money to test out. So until I'm comfortable with paper trading on the new strategies, then I would trade it on actual money. So in conclusion is that the solution for you to solve this undercapitalized problem is that you need to be sufficiently capitalized before you even start trading. And if you're not adequately capitalized now. That is, if you don't have at least 1.5 times of the initial margin, you just don't trade. But that's not the problem, right? You can continue to build your bankroll and getting real time ready for real time trading while you are learning the techniques, the skills of trading on paper. And the fourth mistake, which most commonly people do, is the over leverage. Now, over leverage is very closely related to undercapitalization. Over leverage happens when you are trading large position that's causing you undercapitalization. It causes you to have insufficient funds to withstand the volatility in the market. So let's look at here for example. So let's say if you have 10,000 ringgit in your account and your initial margin per contract is 4,000. So how much should you be trading? So how much will you be trading with 10,000? So can I see how much would you be trading? Is it one lot or two lots or maybe even three lots? Now, here example is that most people would trade two contracts and that's already over leverage. So which means you are actually over leveraged and trading too big than you can actually afford. You are exposing yourself to a significant volatility risk, and this will cause you unnecessary stress in trading, and you feel stressed when having the position. You tend to get emotional. So let's say you see this example, two contracts. So if we divide our account 10,000 by two contracts, so which means per contract, we are using 5,000 to trade one contract. So if we remember the previous example on our undercapitalized, which is the good practice would be have 1.5 times of margin, right? So 1.5 times of 4,000 initial margin, that would be 6,000. So instead of having a minimum requirement of 6,000 to trade one contract, we are trading two contracts, which is already over leveraged. Well, so a good practice would be that.
Right. Yeah. Many of them put a new one. Yeah, very, very disciplined follower.
Yeah.
So very good. Very many good. Of them only selected one.
So one contract is very good because you have really sufficient capital to trade on that. So one contract to trade 10,000 accounts, so which means you have 6,000 buffer to withstand the volatility. But that does not mean that having 6,000 will be good enough. You have to look at your trading strategies, whether you are actually in the right direction or not. And the last one would be most people do not have a trading plan, or they don't have a trading strategies. So knowing how to play a badminton, right? Knowing how to kick a football does not mean that you have an effective and a good strategy to play the game. Many people have learned some form of fundamental analysis or even technical analysis, but they don't have a well-formed trading plan. They don't have a structured trading strategies to trade the market. So now, as we talk about the trading plan, trading strategies, or even trading system, many people are trying to find the perfect trading strategies available out there in the market. Well, if that will be a such case of perfection in this trading business, right, then that would mean in the market that would be no longer have any random inputs, and someone else would have already found the magical solutions of, and they would have been very profitable by now. So a perfect system or a perfect trading approach, it just does not exist. It never has and it never will. And people have been spending so much money out there just to find the silver bullet, or they are doing the chasing, the rainbow chase, and to find the holy grail, to find the best perfect trading system. Well, so far, I haven't seen a real-time trading system based on the so-called the best system that makes money consistently. Well, it makes money sometimes, but over the long period, it actually loses money. So therefore, it is very important for us to, you know, drop out the notion where there is a mystical path of making easy money. So the sooner that you get to the notion of trying to find the best system out of your head, the sooner you will be on the path of successful trading. And
okay.
During these years, right, in following the market, I've also made a point that of following those successful and those very unsuccessful traders. And I have find some common elements to those winners. Well, they limit their losses. They use a good form of money management. They manage their risk very carefully. They have a plan, and they all somehow, right, seem to have a different trading style, so different technique for trading. And none of them have the same secret trading rules. Now, why is having a trading plan is so important? So when you do not know what you need to do when you're trading, you must follow the rules, because following the rules, they will keep you alive. If market conditions fit what your rules suggest, then you can just go for it. If the rules don't fit the conditions, or if the conditions does not follow the rules, you can just pass or just skip the trade. But you don't have to trade every day, right? So the object of having a system and a rule is to run them to your best advantage in trading. You have a trading edge. And you see, some of the most frequently asked by many people is that, what indicators do you use? How much do you cut loss? What period of moving average do you use? What period of RSI do you use? How do you use MACD? How do you use candlestick patterns, chart patterns? Well, honestly speaking, is that I can tell you all the tools that I'm using. What period of SMA, whether do I use RSI? How much do I cut loss? Yet you are still not able to execute it, is because you just only have the tools and you don't have the strategies to execute. So it is, having a strategy is much more important than just looking at those indicators. And most of the people is that they don't understand their indicators deeply enough. And developing strategies out of your trading indicators, and then plan your trade based on your trading strategies. So many people try to learn many trading indicators and have very little understanding of those indicators. They are still stuck at the level of finding the best trading indicators for many years. So the challenge here is that you need to understand your trading rules well enough inside out. You need to develop trading strategies based on your trading tools and test those strategies. And you need to plan your trade by creating a trading plan to fit your personality, to fit your lifestyle, to fit your risk tolerance, and so on. So the conclusion is that, well, now you have all of it. The five deadly mistakes most traders made that cost them money and unnecessary losses. So once you are able to eliminate all these unnecessary losses, right? In fact, you have already, you don't have to find ways to make back all this money, right? So in conclusion is that you need to stop doing all of these common mistakes so that your account won't be bleeding. And if you can just avoid losing money, you are on your way to successful trading and you are getting closer towards your financial goals. And most people can't do that. And what they want to learn is all about making money. So that's why it is so important for you to learn what not to do in trading that loses you money, that costs you unnecessary mistakes and losses. Okay.